Hi, job seekers. Well, let's get straight to the point with cover letters, because a lot of people think it's really cool to call the death of the cover letter. Oh, cover letters are so last year, last decade, last century. Recruiters don't read them anymore. Managers don't read them anymore. I don't use them because I just don't think they're going to get read. Well, I'm here to tell you that that assumption is false. I work with plenty of recruiters, both on the agency and talent acquisition side, and I can tell you that many of them read cover letters. In fact, I know that some of them read cover letters before they read the resume. So if you're sitting there thinking, I'm not sending out a cover letter at the moment, I didn't think it was worth it, well, you're taking a huge risk, because let's look at it in this simple way. When you apply for a job, you can do two things: submit a resume, submit a cover letter. Now, one way you can actually make your cover letter really stand out from the rest of the pack is by doing one simple thing, and that is using the person's name that you're sending the cover letter to. If it's on the advertisement, it's quite simple. Put Dear James. But if there's no name on the advertisement, this could actually be a way for you to really stand out as a job seeker. Simply call up reception and say, hey, I'm interested in applying for the accounting job. I just would like to know who to address my cover letter to. If the receptionist gives you the name of the person and you're the only cover letter with the name of the hiring manager on the on that document, they are probably going to be intrigued, and that could be enough to make you stand out to get that phone call to progress through to the next round. Have a cover letter, make sure you've got the name on it, and tomorrow I'm going to go into more detail about how you can make yours stand out. See you then.